He's only MP in government at the moment, and after this Saturday, he's hoping he'll still be there.
Whatever happens, National MP Sam Lotu-Inga is confident the voters in Auckland's Maunga Kiakia seat will put him back in the House.
First thing I want to say, guys, is thank you for coming to join us today, and what we're trying to do is get our message out, you know.
Less than a week out from Election Day.
Try and get more support for the National Party, and certainly for me here in Maunga Kiakia. So,
and Besitar Sam Lotu-Inga is doing his best to win back the seat he took in 2008.
I'm Sam, I'm the local MP. Nice to meet you. Yeah, I'm good, mate. How are you?
The National MP won Maunga Kiakia by nearly 2,000 votes at the last election. Previously, it had been held by Labour. This time around, he's the incumbent MP, and it's been a tough campaign at times.
Yeah, I felt something, you know, in terms of, you know, some people are just naturally frustrated and angry, and, you know, we get rude remarks at street corners. But I think the overall feeling has been one of, you know, of optimism, though. People have understood that we've encountered some natural disasters that have, you know, had a huge impact on not just Christchurch or Pike River, but the country.
One of the tough nights of the campaign came at a housing meeting in the neighbouring Tamaki electorate. As the only National MP present, Besitar copped a tongue lashing.
You've got families here that are going to lose their homes and they're not going to be able to come back.
People want to vent and feel frustrated. I think, you know, you've got to have a pretty thick skin in this game, and you just take those sorts of nights and you move on. But, you know, you've got to learn your lessons as well, and that, you know, we need to respond and be sensitive to the needs of people in our communities.
For the record, Besitar plans to raise some of the issues from the meeting with the Housing Minister. In the meantime, he's got an election to win, and hoping to join him in Parliament is another Pacific candidate in Cook Islander Alfred Ngaro, who, as number 37 on National's list, stands a good chance of getting in.
Well, just my community, my children, my family encouraged me to do that. They said, look, you know, it's time for you to sort of put your name forward, and especially for leadership for our community and our people. You know what the issues are, you've worked in community, and said, how about sort of taking those concerns and those voices and aspirations through into Parliament.
For Besitar, Ngaro's selection's more evidence National's serious about courting the Pacific vote, traditionally Labour Party territory.
John Key has signalled that. He believes that, you know, our caucus and our party should reflect New Zealand. And, you know, I said when I was made a Member of Parliament in 2008, I'm not the first Pacific person to be in the National Party as a Member of Parliament. I certainly won't be the last.
So as the election nears, the MP's hoping he'll be returned to Parliament and given the chance to build on his first term. He's hoping Pacific people will also see the value in what his party offers.
Well, you know, I believe the National Party actually have values that equate with what Pacific people stand for. You know, we're about family, strong communities. We're about aspiration. We came here for higher education. We came here for better jobs, for a better standard of living. We didn't come here for dependency and you know, relying on government for everything in our lives. That's not what we stood for in the Pacific, and that's not what we stand for here.